We've covered the basics of sigma notation and sigma sums, so let's compute some given some explicit series here. The first one is finding the sum k equals 1 to 5 of 1 over k squared plus 8. So what we're going to do is we're going to start at the lower index, and we're going to walk up to the upper index, and we're going to change this expression here each time and see what each expression is. And it's actually easier done than said, which sounds odd. So we're going to start with k equals 1, and then we're going to do k equals 2, k equals 3, k equals 4, all the way to k equals 5, because that's our start and end index. So if we do 1 over k plus 8, we do 1 over 1 squared plus 8, 1 over 2 squared plus 8, 1 over 3 squared plus 8, 1 over 4 squared plus 8, and 1 over 5 squared plus 8. So in this particular case, this is 1 ninth, and 1 twelfth, and 1 seventeenth, 1 24th, 1 33rd. So we would say this is equal to 1 ninth plus 1 twelfth plus 1 seventeenth plus 1 24th plus 1 33rd, which I believe is like 3, 2, 5, 2, something like that. It's hard to say. And anyway, so that's the idea. At each term, we change. So k is here. So that's the only thing that changes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in each term, k was squared. So we just add the terms together and we get this. Now over here, we have the same. We have a series, or a sum rather. We have a sum and the term is just some c, some arbitrary c. Now I know that I start at 0. And then I go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And in each term, I'm supposed to change if I see the index. Well, the index doesn't appear in that expression. So anything that's not the index, you just copy. Like over here, it was 1 in the numerator and 8 in the denominator. And then, of course, the addition symbol. That stayed the same each time. So 1 and 8. And then plus is here. And then, of course, the exponent as well didn't change. The only thing that changed was based on the index. Now, over here, I don't have an index in the expression. So, in the first case, it's just C. And then it's just C. And then C, and C, and C, and C. So, it's 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 C's. And I didn't bound that one. But that's the idea. And this is a little odd because you expect to get some sort of numerical value, but you're not going to because the expression doesn't include anything that's going to give you a numerical value.